everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. A live look at Houston, Texas right now, where the Rice Owls are on the field at home and hoping to show the wisdom of believing that they can get a victory on their own turf. That's going to do it for us. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming right at you. Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I are back at halftime.
Texas for this football matchup at Rice Stadium.
It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Both teams are lining up for the kickoff, and we're just about set to get this one underway. Takes it at the 4, and he's taken down at the 27-yard line.
Louisiana Tech's coaching staff, they know they've got a star wide receiver. They know it's going to be a hostile environment. With that, we went to practice this week, Kirk. They had a crowd noise pumped up pretty good getting them ready for this game.
Yeah, they've done everything that they can do to get this offense ready for a tough environment. They had the crowd noise all week long, making it tough to communicate to the quarterback and his receivers. Now it's here. Now it's the game, and we'll see if all that preparation pays off. One thing we know for sure, they want to get the football into the hands of this receiver early and often if they want to win this game.
From their own 30-yard line, second down. And they get the sack.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush because sacks can be real drive killers.
So that sack will back them up a little now. They're looking at a difficult 3rd and 13. And that one's incomplete. There was not a soul open there.
He threw into double coverage because it was an obvious passing down, and the defense knew the pass was coming.
Moore back deep to return. At the 48. They'll certainly need better production from this offense as the game goes on.
Well, they had their opportunities here to make some plays to try to quiet this crowd, but they weren't able to do it. If things keep going this way, this stadium is going to get even louder.
Tackle at the 40.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
Can't get away. Nice tackle.
When this guy gets his arms around a ball carrier, I don't care who it is, he's not getting away.
They'll bring him down at about the 41.
That's a loss of 1 yard on the play. That makes it 3rd and 11.
Man left.
Tackle made right around the 30.
You know, they pick up some great yards here on the ground. You got to be wondering if the quarterback would love to have had a chance to throw the football to be able to see if he could get the first down. But nonetheless, they do pick up some good yards.
Rice could take the lead with this field goal. He gets it up, and it's long enough, and he got it. get the latest now from Reese Davis.
Time to go to the Little Apple in Manhattan. This was a tight one to the very end. The Tigers walked out with a 7-point win.
Reese, 3-0 here. Ford has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the three. Rice is looking right now like they've got all three phases working for him so far, Kirk.
Yep, it's early, but they are in control of this game. The defense seems to have a very good feel for what they're doing out there. The offense moved the ball down the field. Special teams, everything right now is really in sync for this team.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Dumps it out left to the running back, and down he goes at the 17-yard line. From their own 17-yard line, second down. And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five-receiver look. Quick throw out to the receiver. And he's taken down around the 28-yard line.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
Third and one coming up on this play. Ball on their own 28. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. Gets to about the 47-yard line. The offense goes back out onto the field after picking up a field goal on their last drive. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Now he's scrambling. He's at the 40, brought down to the 38-yard line. Rice has got a guy behind center that can really do it all, Herbie. I mean, he's a dual threat. He can hurt you with his feet and his arm. With this guy, it's PYP. Pick your poison. Rice is up by three. Tackled after a decent pickup.
That makes it second and six.
He's tackled around the 34-yard line.
That'll bring up third and six.
He's going to try and scramble. They'll make the sack.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
In a perfect world, he knocks this kick down inside the 10. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Let's get some points going right now. Not a lot of offense here in the opening quarter.
I'm with you. I'd like to see a lot more offense than we've seen up to this point. Give credit to the defenses, but I think you're going to see both these offense coordinators get more of a feel for things and start to adjust their play call.
And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. He's taken down around the 17-yard line.
These corners are showing that they're not afraid to come up and make a hit. Even if they aren't playing pass, they know how to disrupt the play.
It's second and 13. Ball on the 17-yard line. Both offenses trying to find their rhythm in that first quarter. Low scoring and close right now. 3-0, Owl. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. He's tackled at the 31. He's out to the 30. First down. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 31-yard line. He might have a chance. Runs outside for a nice game.
Game of seven on the play. That'll bring up second and three.
And they make the stop around the 38-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. They come out in a five-wide set. Catches it, and he's looking for more. Out of bounds, right around the 42-yard line.
Wow, that was close. I think the officials marked the spot correctly, and it gives them the first by an eyelash. You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 42. Straight run, and he's brought down in the backfield. And this is the eighth play of the drive. A screen pass, gets it to the back, and they got to him before he could get back to the line.
That'll bring up fourth and 13.
Drew awaits the snap. Moore fields it at the 27. He's tackled at the 37-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Rice is up a field goal. He's scrambling. And he is drilled at the 44-yard line.
That makes it 7-2.
He's at the 40, and he's tackled at the 31-yard line. And that was an outstanding run by that young man.
Brad, you're exactly right. The ball carrier is able to break through the secondary without much resistance at all.
He's at the 20. Makes it out to about the 16.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run, and that creates chances in the play-action passing game.
The 10. And that sets them up for the first and goal.
That's another first down, Brad. And right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in. Their ability to pick up first downs, just pushing this defense further and further down, back deep into their own territory.
Almost picked off.
Brady drops the ball here. I don't know if he's starting to peek downfield and think about the return or what, but that ball's right in his hands. He just dropped it.
It's second and goal. Ball on the 6. And they'll get him in the backfield.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
Rice holds a field goal lead. And he tackles him hard at the 19. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
It's fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. Kicks away, and it is good. Reese Davis joins us in the studio with this update. Reese?
The Horned Frogs took the field ranked 11th, but hoping an impressive win could move them into the top 10. And for TCU, they scored through the air.
And for Manning, two kickoff returns, I guess, not good enough. He's now taken a third back to the house.
After this performance, only one way to describe him. Flat boy dog warrior.
Upset special happens every year. Maybe it's one of those weekends. Ford gets set to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He gets out to about the 18-yard line.
And we're getting so used to pinball football with a lot of points. Kind of fun to see defenses play this way.
Kind of refreshing, isn't it? I mean, every single week we call games, and you're seeing scores in the 30s and 40s. This is one of those low-scoring games. Which offense will get that big break? Eventually, it could be the team that wins it.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
He's pushed out of bounds at the 24.
That'll make it second and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He flings it left. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
Man left, man left. Four down, four down. Mike 51, Mike 51.
He's tackled in the open field.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
From the 42-yard line, first down. Here's a handoff up the middle and no room to run.
They don't have enough time to play dink and dunk football like this. They need to move the ball and do it quickly.
A quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Throws it out, and it falls incomplete.
You know, sometimes the toughest throws to make for a quarterback is when he has a wide receiver wide open, and everybody in the stands is saying, throw it, throw it. And you aim the football instead of just getting back in rhythm, stepping, and throwing. And that time, he aimed the ball, and it was incomplete.
That's a great tackle at the 8-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
Quickly, and they got it. Touchdown. The kicker on the field. He'll try to put his team up by a point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A 7-play, 81-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
So our score, 7-6. He's to the 20. And down he goes to the 24-yard line.
This offense is just going to be kicking themselves. They're moving the ball very well. In fact, they're getting into their opponent's territory. The only problem is they're not finishing off the drives with touchdowns. They're having to settle for field goals. That could eventually catch up to them.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Got it. And brought down immediately. 7-yard play.
That's a good completion. They didn't get the first down, but they picked up about 7 yards.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Steps out of bounds at the 33-yard line.
It is for a quarterback to know that he's got a receiver like this who can step up when he needs him on third down.
First and 10, ball on their own 45. Throws left, the running back's got it. They'll bring him down at the 44. Good gain on the pass to the running back.
This young man is becoming more and more part of this passing game. He does a great job of making guys miss after the catch.
Scrambling around. Rice has called their final timeout. So we'll probably get one last heave to the end zone here before halftime. He sails it long. Finds his receiver. Touchdown.
This guy just continues to impress me. Every time I watch this team play, he seems to come up with big plays.
The coverage just couldn't keep up with him there. And he tacks on the extra point. A 6-play, 75-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
You know, you can throw the football as well as these guys can. You don't necessarily always have to have a balanced attack because you're so proficient in throwing the ball.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half.
Maybe the most important statistic from the first half, no turnovers for either team. So far, a good job of ball security, but now you wonder if the quarterbacks can avoid putting the ball in jeopardy. They're going to want to make a big play, and that might sort of set off a feeding frenzy on the defensive side.
Yeah, and it's in defenses, that's the number one priority. I mean, you can give up a lot of yards. They can chew up yards up and down the field, but if you can force turnovers, then you're keeping them off the scoreboard, and that's your number one goal. So defenses, they have to be a little bit upset right now, and they got to try to find ways to hit harder. How about when you're tackling? Use the strip stick, you know, be able to strip the ball out, get the ball out, try to get some interceptions, try to make some user picks, you know, do whatever you can to try to get the football back from that offense and set your offense up in good field position.
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herb Street's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know, something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. I mean, always got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
Great first half and a tight ball game, and we're set to start quarter number three. From the 5-yard line. And he's taken down at the 35-yard line.
Both teams are kind of struggling to take control of this game. Obviously, they're both very, very competitive with one another. It just seems that the lead is going back and forth between the two teams.
So we're just about ready to return to action. Rice with a 6-point lead. And he's taken down at about the 45. Came down with it. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Quick strike and he drops it. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45. and completes.
Black was the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up fourth and nine.
The punt upcoming, and they're going to come after this one. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Tackle outside after a nice pickup.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Complete for 6 yards, and that's good for a first down.
Heads up play by the quarterback to find his receiver in traffic and get the ball into his hands.
They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a 5-wide outlook. Man can't tack on any yardage.
That'll make it second and four.
From their own 46-yard line, second down. He gets to about the 41-yard line, so he keeps it and he gets a big first down.
Quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
He heaves it to the end zone. The defender had it and then dropped it.
That makes it second and ten.
It's second and ten. Ball on the 41-yard line. Now they need to get it down to the 31. And he's tackled at the 25.
At the 25-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground incomplete. From the 25-yard line, it's second down. The Bulldogs lost one of their key guys earlier to that injury, and unfortunately, I don't think he's going to play any more football today. Setting up blockers, your running back's got it on the screen. This is the 10th play of this drive. Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. Tackle at the 13-yard line.
Harris makes the tackle at the 13-yard line.
First down. It's first and 10. Ball on the 13-yard line. He's taken down at the 15. This is the 12th play of this drive. What a play to set him up with a first and goal.
Stokes makes the tackle at the 3-yard line.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. He scrambled, and he's going to run this one in, touchdown. So the quarterback decided to improvise and took it in for the touchdown.
This is why this guy is such a special player. This is what makes the offense even more difficult to stop. When a quarterback can take it himself and run, that's just one more weapon the defense has to account for.
And he adds the extra point. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
Buffalo ready to go in Buffalo. The Bulls have the perfect connection and a touchdown. The Bulls lead it by 7.
And for Rice, they just played Buffalo last week. Louisiana Tech to kick this one off. And he'll return this one from the 7. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. He's to the 40, and down he goes at the 43. Gets it out quickly, and they make the stop at the 45. Sheds that one. He's tackled at about the 47-yard line. Grabs it, and he might go the distance. Touchdown, Rice!
This is textbook. They were able to freeze the safety with the play action, leaving the wide receiver plenty of room to get in for the score.
And they're looking to get 2 points here. Play 72-yard drive, and they add 8 points to their total.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot, and they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
So the score now, 21-14. Rice gets set to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both teams have really answered the bell here in the third quarter.
Well, exciting to see what these offenses have been able to do here. To be able to come out and score in your first drive tells you a lot about what they did during the half.
I was really impressed with their last series. They came out with a focus on the passing game, and the offense got the job done. We'll see if they have the same strategy here.
Got it to the senior. Tackle made right around the 40.
Harris with the tackle at the 40-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 40. Now he's scrambling. And he's level at the 47.
Call it a gain of 13 yards. First down.
Justice! So at the end of the third quarter, Rice leads it 21-14. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. And he snags that one.
And he is drilled at the 38.
Gain of nine on the play. That brings up second and one.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. Receiver and he dropped it.
Mitchell is the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it third and one.
Now he tries to buy some time. Brought down
at about the 17-yard line.
First down.
From the 17-yard line, first down. Sends it out quick, intercepted. Oh, no, they really didn't need that.
And as a quarterback, you can't give up an interception late in the game. You got to be more careful with the football.
Rice is up seven. And he hits him hard at the 14-yard line. Try and scramble. They'll bring him down at the 26-yard line. Here's an opening. He gets out to about the 44-yard line. Come out in a five-wide set. Gets out to around the 45. He's scrambling, and they get the sack.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
It's second down and 11 to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Caught with room to work. And he's taken down right around the 36-yard line.
Right,
carries the ball for a nice game.
Boy, that's another first down, Brad. That's the fifth first down on this drive. You know, this offense isn't hitting a lot of big plays, but they're very, very consistent with their execution. It's putting a lot of pressure right now on this defense.
Tackled for a loss.
He was never able to get ahead of steam on that carry.
Louisiana Tech's going to have to use their second time out of the half. From the 30-yard line, second down. And he's stopped behind the line.
You know, as a running back, you've got to get upfield north and south. That time, he just seemed to wait and kind of delay his reaction and just got to be able to make a read, get upfield as quickly as possible. In college football, and especially up in the NFL, the more you're dancing around waiting for a big play, the more time you're giving an athletic defense a chance to come and make a play in the backfield against you, and that's what happened.
That makes it fourth and four.
So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. He gets it up, and he's got it. Let's check in with Reese Davis in the studio.
We take you now to Fort Worth. TCU takes a 14-point victory. In other action, let's check in over in Buffalo. And for Buffalo, they've won two straight. And for Walker, he had a touchdown catch. Buffalo takes the two-touchdown win.
All right, thanks a lot, Reese. Ford has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. Taken from the 3-yard line. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. Their last drive ended with an interception. We're about to find out what the defense can do this time.
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
And he's going to be sacked for a loss. Spikes the ball.
That'll bring up third and long.
From their own 11-yard line, third down. He's going to air it long. He got it. And he's tackled at the 35.
It definitely put them in better field position. And I just have a feeling that they're going to punch it into the end zone on this drive.
The spike will stop the clock.
That makes it second and 10.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 35. Quick out to his receiver. Tackle at the 23-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
And he stops the clock with a spike.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 23-yard line, second down. Goes to the tight end and knocked away.
I think the quarterback here is very frustrated that the tight end wasn't able to hold on to the football. But like all good quarterbacks and smart quarterbacks, I'm just going to tell that tight end to forget about it and move forward. The last thing you want as a quarterback is to have your tight end or wide receivers dwelling on a drop football.
Fires out quickly to the tailback. Well, the last time down here, they threw an interception. They'd like to erase that memory. Spikes the ball.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 10-yard line, it's second down. Steps up and he's sacked for a loss.
The Bulldogs have to look at this somehow as a positive. Their star player had a great game. They just got to look the next week.
Yeah, it's tough anytime you lose a game to be positive, but if there is anything to be positive about, it's about that performance by this individual. He really did everything that he could do to try to win this football game. Unfortunately, the team ends up losing, but they can't build to the future around his abilities for sure.